Welcome to TaxReader today. I'm Christoph and I'm speaking to you today from Bergen, Norway, from a nice lake in the mountains. And I will speak to you about the best opportunities to live tax-free in Europe. In this article below, I will speak about the three non-dom countries. Non-dom means non-domiciled. These are the countries of England, Malta, and Ireland. And all these countries provide, if you do it right, the opportunities to live almost completely tax-free there. There's an even better option in Europe, that's Cyprus. Cyprus, I have another article coming in a few weeks, so wait for that or just write me and I will tell you about Cyprus. Cyprus is really the place where you can live completely tax-free in Europe, in the EU. In the other countries, it's a bit more difficult and I will tell you now why. I will speak to you about the countries of England, Ireland, at Malta. They have a special English system, the so-called non-domiciled system. In these countries, it's distinguished between your domicile and your residence. Domicile is the place where your father was born, where you lived yourself at least 20 years. So basically, these kinds of rules I will tell you now can only be used by foreigners. By foreigners who didn't live, who weren't born in this country they emigrate to. So if an English people want to take advantage of this non-dom scheme, they should go to Ireland. If Irish should do that, they should go to England, or they both should go to Malta, and Maltese should go to Ireland and England. So basically, you always have no domicile when you come to these countries, but you can have residence. As a EU citizen, you can easily emigrate to all these countries. You basically just have to provide a flat or buy a house, get valid health insurance, and you can register there. Once you are registered, the taxation which can apply to you is the so-called remittance base. Remittance base means you are completely tax-free on foreign income if it's not remitted into this country. So for example, in Malta, you can just be resident in Malta, have a company in Malta, and everything like your investments, foreign income, which you don't use in Malta, won't be taxed there. Of course, you need something to live in all these countries. You need a basic salary of maybe 1,000 euros a month to get by, and this amount of money you have to introduce into the country. Introduction is not only if you wire it to a bank account in the country, it's also if you use a credit card or even get money from the ATM. So what that does basically mean? You pay yourself out a salary of maybe 1,000 a month in Malta. You pay normal taxes on that, like 15%, but the rest of your income could be potentially tax-free. Malta is the easiest non-dom regime. In Malta, you just have to say the government each year the amount of taxes you declared in Malta. So you just have to declare what you brought, in your opinion, to Malta, not your worldwide income. In Ireland, for example, you have to declare your worldwide income. And when the tax is declared, the income declared you brought to Ireland is much, much far away from the income you earned worldwide, then there might be an audit of your personal tax situation. And in England, it's even more complicated. England has the strongest rules on that, but it's still possible. And also in England, you can just use it 7 years. After the seventh year, you have to pay £30,000, after 10 years, £60,000, after 13 years, £90,000. But of course, it's still £90,000 is nothing for billionaires. And that's why London and other English towns are still so popular with billionaires and millionaires. So, non-dom is a pretty easy concept. I hope you understood this. But of course, in all these countries, you have to be careful how to apply it. All these countries have certain rules, for example, against foreign companies. So even in Malta, it's not that easy to actually use a foreign company if you control it from Malta. So you basically have to have substance requirements. If you have a country, maybe in some other country, you should have a local director office there or something else. Otherwise, Malta could tax you like a Maltese company, which is not bad, which is 5%, but that's another topic. So if you're interested to live tax-free or almost tax-free, you should just go to these countries, pay yourself out a little income, pay a little tax on that, pay a little social security on that, but the most of your income all of your income you invest in other countries, especially things like Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies, stocks and so on, could be potentially tax-free. And that's the reason why so many people decide to emigrate to sunny Malta in the Mediterranean, and some people even to cold, rainy Ireland and England. You find much more information